Well, it's happy birthday to me. 59 years ancient. In true tradition, I have pulled out my two-weight, a tradition that started a couple years ago on this river. I have a drone in the air, which will hopefully produce some... Oh my gosh, it feels so nice to have this little two-weight in my hands. I've got a new salmon fly imitation on the end. Having observed 7 adults in the air on my outing 2 days ago, so what I'm hoping to do this morning as a birthday present to myself is get some, oh, that was a take, is to get some cool footage of casting my two-weight out to these aggressive, hungry cutthroat and turn it into one of my favorite movies. Now, it is an interesting feeling to fish with the drone in the air because I take care of my stuff and I don't want to lose track of it or lose battery power and have it drop into the river. So I'm gonna kind of make this first pass through here a little fast. All right, here we go. These are the critical casts right out on that currency. Oh, that was a good size fish that came up and did a swipe, but he did not commit and he did not appear to want to eat it. Let's work the water instead of the particular fish. There we go. That's just a little guy. But, oh, and he's off. All right, let's dry that fly off a little bit. That's a good, encouraging sign. There we go. That's a good size fish. That's a better size fish. All right, it's not a big one, but definitely worth the effort. Spunky. I believe that got our fly out of there already. Yes. Nope, not quite. All right, there we go. It's going to be a bit of a shit show, but I could probably turn it into some fun movie stuff. No idea if that got caught on the drone, given the angle I'm looking down and seeing. But we'll find out shortly, because I'm going to go land that sucker again. So the funniest part about trying to do this all at once is it takes away a little bit of the relaxation factor of this fly fishing. Because I'm worried about the drone, and I'm worried about the GoPro, and I'm worried about my fly. But... I keep reminding myself why It's so much fun to do it anyway. So we have a freshly dressed fly, a fresh battery in the drone. We're gonna hook another one on video. And so 1 year ago right now, I was looking at a video last night. 1 year ago, this very moment, I had this two-weight out and I hooked a big old 18-inch cutthroat on a salmon fly imitation. And that fish just beat the hell out of me on this little gear. I did end up landing him, but it was something of a challenge. But hey, that's why we're out here, right? Go, that's a better fish. That is a way better fish. Oh, and he's off. Oh, I gotta look at him though. Dang it. I think he's off. Oh my gosh, he came right at me. He's still on. Wow. I gave up on that fish for a second. With a barbless hook, when a fish comes straight at you like that, it is very easy for that hook to slide out. And I just got lucky, that's all there is to it. He's not a giant either, but I will take it because... Oh, all right, we're in the net. Let's go ahead and take care of this guy real quick, like, because I want to get that drone out of the air. Ah, now I see why the hook didn't come out. That thing was, that hook was right in the corner of his jaw, which is a pretty secure spot. Okay, I don't see my drone. We'll see how this works out. All right. The drone is safely tucked away, stowed away in its padded bag, hiding in the bushes. I have since retied. I'm back to a salmon fly. I have gone to the bottom of this beautiful run to start working it diligently from bottom to top with my two weight still, of course. Whole new level of relaxation without worrying about that expensive machine being in the air. But the funniest thing that happened was that I went to turn on the GoPro to record this little segment and the camera had been running the whole time. So I taped a bunch of wasted stuff of collecting the drone and packing it and everything else. Fortunately, I was carrying a second GoPro battery as well. I got to see a good part of this take from this nice boy. Oh, he's got some size. And I can really feel it on this two-weight. Yeah, this is a nice fish, but once I feel like I have control of him, he can pretty much go wherever he wants. I got no horsepower. But I got to see the better part of that take. One of those ones that kind of happen in slow motion. Got some girth. get the sense he's not done yet. But even landing fish with this little two weight is quite a bit more challenging. It just lacks a little bit of backbone to get to this point. Oh, that's a nice fish. All right, let's see where our fly is. Well, we're just gonna handle this guy because I think it'll be the easiest way get that fly out of there. Right there in the corner again. Here we go. That's beautiful. Let's see if we can get some good video of him swimming away, darting away. All right. We are all freshly dressed. Had a fresh dip for our last attempts at these fast water cutties. Yeah, this is just harder, tougher fly fishing right here when we're casting right into this fast water. It is just necessarily harder to get a really good dead drift, and most of the interest that you see is right after the fly hits the water, which is okay. But it seems like in this kind of fishing, and this is historically true, it seems like you basically only get one shot at a fish. Oh, like they might go for it once, but to get them to come back, even if they haven't felt the hook, is the challenge. There we go. He came a long ways to get that fly. Holy crap. The effort was worth it. This fish came darting out of that white water from a good, what seemed like 4 or 5 feet away to snatch this fly. And he's still out there in the current, which makes horsing him impossible with this two weight. Boy, he's got some size because he is just horse or bulldogging me. He's just keeping his head down. Oh yeah, that's a beauty. Well, and the lesson learned is that we have definitely arrived at the point where these cutthroat are starting to make their way into this faster oxygenated water, which obviously applies to every future trip. It's kind of a luxury of the early season when they are hanging out in the most convenient water to fish, but as the season progresses, as the temperature of the water and the air rises, they start to go look for this faster water. Beautiful. Another football. He is thick. Nope. I got a little anxious. Understandable with a feather light fly rod in my hand. The rod, obviously, and I'm not trying to. There we go. All right, get it out of your system, buddy. You're going back. Oh, fly's already out. How convenient is that?